Aki Karim for British boxers. Yes, we're down here at Northside. We got the Roadmen with us. Quinny. We got Curtis G. Boys, just seeing you there in a good session there. Working hard this morning, aren't you, boys?
By the way, wait a minute. Curtis G, called Curtis the Entertainer Gargano.
I'm Jamie the Devil Child Quinn.
Now,
you know me, I'm undefeated and he's undefeated as well. At eating pies.
I'm only joking.
What I've noticed about you this morning is that, you know, from all the joking aside and everything, you put in a good shift this morning, aren't you?
My first day back, I'm feeling a bit sluggish today, but that's all to be expected, right?
That's all what he does.
The Christmas binge.
Quinny, does it help having Curtis with you, you know, training with you as well, journeyman in a way.
Yeah, of course, definitely. Like, it's good to see. We watch for each other, like, we learn a few tricks off each other. Like,
now it's good to catch up with Quinny because he trains at night and I have to train through the day because of my kids and what I've got to do. So I only ever see Quinny really. Rather than we getting battered on a show together, we're in the morning. We get to catch up, don't we? Like once a month, twice a month.
I'm going to be here for mornings now.
I hope so.
Is it like? Better for you to train with other people on the road, or is it better for you to train with you know, what does that work for you?
It's good to train, no, because listen, Quinny's one of the hardest trainers, isn't he, mate? And it's good to train with Willie and Quinny, because we all buzzy off each other, and if we're in the gym enjoying it, and there's nothing better than being in the gym. Good training hard and enjoying it. Enjoying it, you know what I mean? It's good when you're in the gym on your own, it's more serious, isn't it? Yeah. You mean it's a hard game, this, mate? Dieting and, you know, training every day, so it's good to be happy in here.
And I understand that there might be some, in the new year, there might be a time when you're both on the sort of same show on the road, and perhaps maybe even York Hall, perhaps?
Yeah. It looks like I'm going to go on that York Hall, me, him and Dale.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, well, what it is with me and Quinny, like, what's mad is that, like, I got my corners badge last year, and we went all the way to Kent. It was a long day, wasn't it, man?
He did my corner, and then I think it was about three fights later, he got my corner, got out of his kit, and then jumped in the fight.
So we had to go all the way down there. We had to do his wraps, we had to get him ready, get him warmed up, and then I had to do his corner, which was my first corner I've ever done, so it was pretty hard, and he's like a diva, you know what I mean? He's used to having everything done. I was like, wow, this is hard, isn't
it?
He's a diva. He's a diva in there.
What makes you such a diva?
Oh, the hell.
He likes things, does he's used to Joe, and he's like having it done his way. But we did good though, didn't we?
Yeah, he did well in the corner. Because he knows like what we're up to like there as a journeyman thing. So he just told us, he said, yeah, keep your defence, like, you're doing well, mate. I enjoyed that fight, we had a lot of
fun. And then next minute, I'm in the ring and I can hear him outside. Like,
give me the shuffle.
And the funny thing was, man, when we boxed that day, because I was being a bit cocky doing a few antics like I do in the ring, and the guy's crowd who was fighting was all wanted to kick off with us, didn't they?
Oh,
he's waiting for us.
He's there giving it all this.
And then he
sat on that guy's table like, come on, Curtis. Come on, they all turned around, looked at me like, oh, fuck.
Mate, we more or less got flipping drove out of there, mate.
Now, on an interesting note, though, you're both quite entertaining in the ring. You know, like, obviously, Curtis, you know, is the entertainer. Quinny, you beat your chest and you do that whole thing. Now, that's part of it, though, isn't it? That's part of being a good journeyman.
The reason I do it, like, a lot of people say, like boxers do it when they hurt. Like, I don't do it. If I hurt, I've got to go into my shell table. I do because I think they're either going to come at me with everything they've got, like burn their energy out, and it's going to give me like an idea of how hard they're going to hit, or they're going to think, shit, like, no, I'm not going to stop this guy, we're going to take a bite.
Sometimes.
And obviously sometimes it does, it winds him up, it gets to the red
light. Sometimes it can work in many effects, man. It can work, like, if these kids are coming on very strong, it slows them down and it gives you a couple of seconds breather. You know what it does, it makes them think. And then the other time it's to entertain the crowd as well. And sometimes it's to warm yourself up and get yourself geared up, you know what I mean?
I just like doing it me sometimes. I like just thinking, no, you're not hurting me, like, but obviously because, like, sometimes you get into their crowd, and they're all like to think, man, you hear their crowd shouting, oh, you've got him, this, you've got him. Sometimes I just like to say, like, look, you're not hurt.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, I get it. And adjusting. Also, on a serious technical note, you know, fighters on fight day, they have certain, very certain preparations. You guys, a lot of the time, you're driving long distances, your nutrition's up and down because, you know, travel. How do you manage that?
My routine is just the same training routine all the time, so obviously you never know when you're going to get called in, but obviously like sometimes I get told I've got to like get down to featherweight or something, some jumping up and down. So like it's just the only thing I usually change really is the diet. But like if the weight's gonna kill me getting it down from too short notice.
Listen, mate. Quinny, tense up, man. Quinny's in shape all the time. Look. Quinny's in shape all the time. It's not like me. I eat a biscuit. I put on a stone. He needs a biscuit now. I put on a stone. He needs to eat to make the weight. If I had his body, I'd be a super welterweight.
Just jealous,
innit? So I am jealous.
Is this the year for the journeyman then, this one?
Yeah. I'm definitely going to pick up a few wins this year. And if people start pulling out, then I'll start trash talking, calling back out there.
And Kurt, moving down in weight, definitely.
Yeah. It's going a bit slow now. You know, been dipping the biscuits a little bit too long, Anna. But we're on it. I'm not fighting now. Like I'm gonna give it another 7 week camp now, and I'll be back. I'm looking to be super middleweight and then work way down to middleweight.
Yeah, man.
Doing it properly.
I'm gonna be all the way with this camp. I'm gonna be here every
morning. Gonna be some wins coming this year.
Yeah.
Forget that old guy. He's gone. He's finished. I left him in the bin. This is the real Gargano now. I'm coming to take the number one spot.
New year, new Gargano.
Yes.
Boys, it's always look at
the respect. It's a younger out, Curtis, lad.
Nah, not getting no younger.
Now, Quinny, you said before we go, you said there was something you wanted to go off your chest or.
Yeah, I totally forgot.
You forgot?
Yeah, okay.
Nice one. Well, we'll do that next time then.
Yeah, that's what I can.
Boys, nice catching up with you.
You too, mate.
Year of the journeyman. Curtis just on his phone now. He's done for the day.
Yeah, man. Respect British boxers, you know where it's at.
British boxers, respect Aki.
Yeah, Gargano, you know where it's at.
This is the journeyman, Barban. I'm starting to think it's 60 jumps and all that. Looking like that.